I went ahead and did two layers of the sealer on her because she was still kind of smooth feeling. So now she feels it's just like a slight texture. So again, I want to neutralize her orange vinyl because she's very orange. So we look at this, you can see she's yellow, but she's more orange yellow to orange. So it'd be blue violet. So I think I'm just gonna do like a light blue. And the older vinyl, especially with this big head, is hard to do washes on. You end up with streaks everywhere. So I'm just gonna sponge it on. Basically, I'm going to sponge the whole, every color that I do. Because it's easier and the skin tone comes out with more depth and it looks more like real skin. Okay, so let's get our sponge wet here. Again, I'm going to have to get some more sponges because mine are getting pretty gnarly looking. But I mean, they're stained, but they're not dirty. It's just a stain. They come like in big squares. I cut them down. They're used to wash horses with. They're called equine. Yeah. So, I'm going to get some of my kabuki, little cheap kabuki brushes that I use. And I need a extra brush for getting into the little crevices. So I'm going to use ultramarine blue and a little bit of Titan buff. It's kind of an off-white color. So we'll put a couple drops of blue in there and we'll do one. So I got about 4 or 5 drops of blue and like 2 drops of white. Put some satin glazing liquid in. Golden satin glazing liquid. Almost all the products that I use are golden except for my Americana varnish and my sealer, which is Liquitex Matte Gel. And then I use a lot of Reborn FX stuff for like the rooting glue and the eye glue. I think it really works much better than anything else that I've used. Okay. Golden wetting agent and distilled water. I'll have to show you guys how I mix that. It's pretty easy. I just put a tiny bit in the bottom. This is about, I'd say, 118 milliliters, I think. Let's see, it's the same size as this one. Yeah, exactly. 118 milliliters. Well, they look the same. Yeah, they're the same. Maybe a little tiny bit bigger. It is a golden thing, isn't it? I think it was from an old varnish bottle. Okay. Put a little bit more in here. You gotta be careful with the buff because it tends to get chalky, so you don't want to use too much of it. Okay. So, you can see it's still, like, sticks, but not bad, so let's paint that on the sponge here. Get it kind of soaked in. Now I'm going to blot it off because blue is a really strong color. Okay, so I'll start at the back of the head, the neck, and just blot that on there. And then we're going to kind of tap it with the brush so I can get a lot of the big, some of the color off that's sitting there, kind of sitting on top of the vinyl, kind of just soaking up what the excess, you know. Just go along this little line that you've made. Kind of turn your sponge every once in a while because it makes different patterns. This is how I painted. And if anybody's familiar with Katie's Liam that I made for her, his name is Remy now. Katie's Precious Angels Reborn Nursery. I basically did him the same way, just all sponges, all sponge layers. I think I may have done maybe one or two washes on him, but it was mainly the sponge. Like I said, with this older vinyl, it's easier than trying to do washes. When you do washes, it just kind of sticks. Okay, I'm going to use the brush for the ear. Go around the ear. And then I'm going to brush that off with the brush. Kind of make more of a brushing rather than a pouncing. What is that? There's something stuck to her ear. Hold on. And that can pounce and brush. Kind of pounce the inside. Let me get this toothpick. There's a little, I think it's paint from, there we go, from the lid. Sometimes the paints, you know, they dry into the lids. Let me get this neck down here. Like I said, I like the depth that the sponging gives, and they're really thin layers, so they're not thick like modeling. It's really, really thin, like wash layers. I didn't put my camera back up because I can't do that. I have to get my husband, and he's sleeping because I had to wake him up because my physical therapist comes in the morning, but he's going on vacation, so it'll just be Thursday that he's coming. So, and my husband can sleep. Make him happy. He likes sleeping. It's his favorite thing. I'm tired, but I couldn't sleep last night. I have kind of like insomnia. Like as soon as the lights go out, I just start thinking about things that I shouldn't be thinking about, you know, when it's time for bed. There we go. I'm going to have to use the brush around her face, on the features on her face. I'm going to do this ear. Around the back. I'm going to brush that in. There we go. Go on her lip, I think. Get this in really good. Okay, I'm gonna do some brush around her deeper features that I can't reach with the sponge. And I'm going to brush it off with the little brush. Okay. Now you can see she's a little more pale. I'm going to show you with her arm. I don't know if it shows really. Yeah, there we go. You can tell when I hold her back. Okay, so I'll do an arm and a leg. And let me see. That's a little bit too much blue down here on her chin. It's okay. I'm gonna get this slightly wet. I just don't like that on the chin, so dark. Just pounce, because if you smear, then it'll, well, if you move the brush around, it'll smear. If you have a wet brush, then you'll get streaks. Okay, there we go. Okay, so I'll just do an arm and leg, and then that'll be it. Not very exciting today. I think I'll go ahead and we'll do a, I want to go ahead and do like a flesh layer, which, like I said, I don't usually do, but, I want her to be lighter. Maybe I want her to be lighter. We'll see. Might change my mind. I was thinking she'd look cute as a redhead, but I think maybe she'd look better, a little bit darker, I don't know. What do you guys think? Darker or lighter? Either way, it's easier if I get a lighter skin tone to start with. I have just painted babies that were orange. Pretty much this is what I do anyway, is put blue on them. But like there's other color vinyl, like there's the Bountiful Baby vinyl is very, very light. And like this baby right here, and she's very peachy colored, kind of. So I would use probably like a green, a mint green on her. I'll go down the inside of the arm, bounce that off. Way around the other side, kind of stay, you know, don't try not to go over the same spot twice. Kind of light still. Okay, I take that back. You can go over just don't go over the darker spots more than once. The dark spot right there. Well, that's all right, I think. So I'm taking paint right here. What is my cat doing out there? She's crazy. My kitten. She's going crazy out there. Also, when you're doing the sealer, make sure you get the hands really good. Forgot to mention that. What are you doing, Kimmy? Huh? Meow. She's mad because I won't let her in. Okay, I'm going to wipe this off the brush a little bit so I can get this finger in here. Because some of the fingers I'm not reaching with the sponge in the hand. The insides of the fingers. A little bit too much right there. Okay. Will you cut that out, you little turkey? Just turn the arm a little bit and see any spaces where you missed. Just kind of tap it in a little bit. Here, I think I'm going to use the brush in the inside of the arm because I end up going over too much. Tap that in with this. There we go. All right. Trying to get this blue on the tips of the fingers too. Either that looks good. Let's see if I can tell the difference between the arms. Yeah. Oops. You can see this one's. This one's, the blue one's lighter than this one that's not done yet. So, I'm going to go ahead and do a leg, just for demonstration purposes. I'm going to put my paint on the brush. I'm just going to go around like this. It's hard for me to hold these big pieces, so sometimes I've set them down. Okay, I'm gonna put a little bit more, put her here. Wearing my smock again today. Keep paint off my clothes. You almost want to tap it in until you hardly can see it. Barely see it. Okay. Do this bottom part. I finally figured out that I think the little piece of paint right there. I think it is cheaper actually for me just to buy the armatures from places like McPherson's and stuff. They have a lot of armatures because it we figured out the cost for buying from the company, buying the, where are these little pieces of paint coming from? Buying the big roll from the company that makes it. I would like to be able to learn how to make my own, but I don't know what I would make them out of. I don't want anything to come, you know, through the vinyl or anything. So the plastic ones are actually the best, but I'm not even turning my brush. This thing's so heavy. It's a heavy leg. I decided I'm only painting this baby. I was thinking, oh, I should paint another baby. I'm like, no, this one's going to wear me out. It's so heavy. Some of the pieces are, the legs are heavy. Okay. Actually, Liam's legs are really heavy, too. He's a big baby. Okay, I'm going to do the foot. Do the footy foot. That is a lady in Australia. What's the name of her nursery? I can't think of the name of her nursery. She used to do videos. She hasn't done any for about a year. Still Moments Nursery. Right? Yeah. She had these things that you could, like, was it her that had them or was it? Oh, shoot. I threw my sponge on the floor. Good thing we're done. Okay. So, just, you know, do that. And then we'll come back and I'm either going to do, I'll probably go ahead and do, I got some of this new, I got this caramel skin color. I kind of like the idea of her being a little bit darker. Maybe we should just go ahead and do yellow first, get some yellow on her. I think I'll come back and we'll do another layer, so I will be back. Okay, so we're back. I'll go ahead and do a yellow ochre layer. So, mix that up for you. This paint is not very fluid. I think it's lost a lot of it. There's kind of a couple dollops in there, so I would say about 10 drops maybe. Just kind of came out now. I'm going to do a squirt or two of glazing liquid. Brushes. This is, it's not dried out, but it's lost some of its liquid. It's not very fluid for fluid paint, I'll say that. Okay. Always be careful not to put too much water. It's not as, like if you're using Genesis, it's not as runny as Genesis. This is like on the verge of being just slightly, almost there. If I put any more in, it probably wouldn't be good. I'm gonna, I'll go ahead and use it out of here, and then actually I'm going to mix this together. That way we'll have all the same color if I want to use it again. Because sometimes when you make different mixes, it looks a little bit different. Sponge. Sponge. It's dry. I need to get it wet. I have another container somewhere. I didn't put that blue away yet, so there we go. I'll get this out. So I'm stuck to the bottom. There's a lot of yellow in your skin. So I use like two different colors of this, like darker yellow. Like I use this and I use raw sienna. Okay, so just the same thing. We'll pat this in. I'll just do her head and then I can show you guys how she looks. I'll have to play around with that. I'll play around with the caramel skin tone off camera, so before I go putting it on a baby. See, I'm being good. I'm getting better. Don't experiment on your babies that you're working on. Experiment on test pieces. To keep telling myself that. Looking good. I like when you put the blue and yellow layers on, it already starts looking like more like skin to me anyway. I know it seems like I keep doing the same colors, but I do use different colors for different babies. But it just turns out that these babies needed never mixed white into the paint. See, that's something new. After this, we'll do like a little bit of powders just to get them started. And someone asked me if the powders wash off or whatever. And they can if you don't like, if you don't use a like a fixative or a medium to. I just like doing it this way, so I just put it, I put the, I'm just dabbing the yellow on and then brushing it off like I did with the blue. I just like, putting the paint over the top of it. Cheeks still looks dark. Uh-oh. I got a little bit of, got a little glob of blue here. I'll put this little bit of water on my little Q-tip. I can just wipe that off. I don't want to wipe too much so I'll end up with white spots. Yellow is the easier color. You don't have to worry as much about smearing and stuff because it's easier to, it covers, you get better coverage, and like if we put more paints over the top of it. With blue, kind of still stands out, so you have to be more careful with it. She does look a lot more pale now. Hard maybe to see on camera. My babies look better in real life than on camera. They look pretty good. I can do pretty good pictures that look real life. Like, I have to show you guys. I did the lashes on the little giveaway baby, so I'll have to show her to you. She's in my room, but I'll stop the camera and go get her as I finish up this little head.
head.
Do you hear what I said? Little. This big giant head. I'm going to have to stop rooting. I'm kind of a perfectionist. I root my hairs really, really close together. So I'm going to have to start spacing the hairs apart, or it's going to take me forever to root any of these toddlers. Like, it looks better anyway when you root, especially when you're using like human hair. If you root too thick, it doesn't look very good. Baby, I'm doing now. I'm trying to root a little bit lighter, but still, they're so close together that. And I'm also doing, you know, mono root like human hair. It's way easier. Mono root, then, because it's thicker and you can see each strand better. I do use a magnifier. There we go. And you can see the difference. Okay, so I'll go get the giveaway baby. Be right back. Okay. Here she is. I don't know, she looks darker on camera, but she's lighter. And she has a lot of you know, the blushing and stuff. And look how cute she looks with the little bonnet on. So cute. Maybe have to crochet her a new bonnet, because this one doesn't seem to. Oh, that's okay. Maybe I'll give her this one. It's got a few snags in it. I'll make her a new one. Make her a little pink one or something. You can see her little eyelashes. And she turned out cute, so my husband and I will have to get her all, get her little body put together, and I can show you guys what she looks like put together, and then we'll get ready to do the drawing. Okay, so thanks for watching, and I hope you like and subscribe. And you can ring the bell if you want to know when I release videos. So, I hope you guys will go out and buy an older, like, cheaper kit. Get some paint, and you guys can follow along painting with me. Hopefully, someday I'll get... We'll get our fiber internet out here, and I can do live videos. That would be fun. Okay, so I will see you guys soon. In the next video, we'll do another layer on this baby. I'll have to decide what that will be. Probably purple. And I'll probably do some details with powder, too. So, and I know Predictable. That's it. Blue, yellow, purple. Promise we'll do some new stuff. All right. See you soon. Bye.